أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ومن يهاجر في سبيل الله يجد في الأرض مراغما كثيرا وسعة، ومن يخرج من بيته مهاجرا إلى الله ورسوله ثم يدركه الموت فقد وقع أجره على الله، وكان الله غفورا رحيما. وإذا ضربتم في الأرض فليس عليكم جناح أن تقصروا من الصلاة إن خفتم أن يفتنكم الذين كفروا، إن الكافرين كانوا لكم عدوا مبينا. وإذا كنت فيهم فأقمت لهم الصلاة فلتقم طائفة منهم معك وليأخذوا أسلحتهم، فإذا سجدوا فليكونوا من ورائكم ولتأتي طائفة أخرى لم يصلوا فليصلوا معك وليأخذوا حذرهم وأسلحتهم. ود الذين كفروا لو تغفلون عن أسلحتكم وأمتعتكم فيميلون عليكم ميلة واحدة، ولا جناح عليكم إن كان بكم أذى من مطر أو كنتم مرضى أن تضعوا أسلحتكم، وخذوا حذركم، إن الله أعد للكافرين عذابا مهينا. فإذا قضيتم الصلاة فاذكروا الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبكم، فإذا اطمأننتم فأقيموا الصلاة، إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن شاء الله continue سورة النساء آية number 100. Already we started this ayah, but we did not finish talking from this ayah because it is very important ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. And whoever immigrates for the cause of Allah will find on the earth many alternative locations and abundance. So I think we spoke about the word al-hijrah and the different meanings of al-hijrah. There is a meaning of al-hijrah. When we mention the word al-hijrah, immediately it comes to our mind to leave the bad place to good place, fi sabilillah, in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that time during the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, mainly it is from Mecca to Medina. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stopped this kind of hijrah after the fatih, when Mecca became a Muslim country, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا hijrata بعد الفتح. There is no hijrah, no migration after the fatih. Mecca conquest means. Okay, it doesn't mean that the hijrah stopped totally. Why? Because we have another hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تنقطع الهجرة حتى تنقطع التوبة. The hijrah doesn't stop until the repentance stops. And when the repentance stops, when the sun rises from the west, which means the hijrah is something until the day of judgment. Okay? So there is a meaning of hijrah from Mecca to Medina. And this one stopped during the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is another hijrah, okay? The hijrah from the non-Muslim country to the Muslim country, or from the place where there are a lot of sins to a place less sins where there is obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is obvious. And the general hijrah, وَالْمُهَاجِرْ مَنْ هَجَرَ مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. When you stop the sins, you are muhajir. وَالْمُهَاجِرْ مَنْ هَجَرَ مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. If you stop, anything for Allah forbids from, this is hijrah, which means the hijrah of sins. Because what is the meaning of hijrah in Arabic language? I mean the linguist meaning to leave. خلاص اهجر. When the father, when Azar said to his son Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام وهجرني مليا, leaves me, مليا means long time. وهجر خلاص leave me. Okay, so يهجره يتركه. Okay, so the hijra doesn't stop. The hijra doesn't stop, which means to leave the sins. But here the condition is في سبيل الله. This hijrah, migration, should be fi sabilillah, not for a woman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the famous hadith, "Innama al-amalu bil-niyat, wa innama likulli imrin ma nawa." فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله, فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله. Sake for Allah subhanahu wa taala, and for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ومن كانت هجرته إلى دنيا لدنيا يصيبها. Okay, why? Because there is a better job. أو امرأة ينكحها. Okay, because of her wife, because a woman to marry. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is a famous story about Muhajir ibn Qais. Someone migrated for what? A woman called Qais. He wants to marry that woman. So his hijrah will not be rewarded because his intention was for that woman. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your intention. Why you migrate to a Muslim country? People know what people know, that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah knows that you migrate for the job or for a wife or for a friend, whatever. So the condition here, fi sabilillah, wa man yuhajir fi sabilillah. What do I mean, the condition? The condition of to get that result. Yajid fil ardi muragaman kathiran wa sa'ah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wa man yuhajir fi sabilillah, yajid fil ardi muragaman kathiran. Not only muragaman, and muragaman, they say muragaman from ragam, al-ragam al-turab, the dust or the sand. Okay, what makes the kuffar feeling bad and feeling angry because you left the kuffar country and you escaped from them and you lived in another country to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to make them angry and upset, muragaman. يرغمه التراب. Okay, when you say يرغمه التراب, someone, one of your enemies. Okay, what's mean يرغمه التراب? Putting the رغام, the dust, in his nose to make him upset and angry. طيب يرغمه التراب مراغما. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said كثيرا وسعة, which means that don't insist in being in one place. Don't think that the خير will be only from this door, only from this job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can replace you many things. طيب Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عسى ربه أن يبدله, من سورة التحريم, أن يبدله خيرا, سورة التحريم. Yes, عسى ربه إن طلقكن أن يبدله أزواجا خيرا منكن مسلمات مؤمنات قانتات تائبات عابدات سائحات ثيبات وأبكارا. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى can replace you other wives, other than your wives or your wife, the one who spoke, or in Surah Al-Tahrim, two of the wives, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Hafsa and Aisha. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, عَسَى رَبُّ إِن طَلَّقَكُنْ, if the Prophet ﷺ divorces you, Allah will replace you. زوجات. What are the attributes of these زوجات, of these wives? Okay, they are better than you. مسلمات, مؤمنات, قانتات, تائبات, عابدات, سائحات, ثيبات, وأبكار. So, you are not the only good women. There are other women who can be better than you, and these are their criteria, رضي الله تعالى عنهم. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى can give you better than what you left for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وسعة, here they say the word سعة, it is نكرة, وزن النكرة ساعة can mean many things. يعني here in the, they put in translation, okay, and abundance. And from the word ساعة something vast, wide. طيب, so Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give you رزق, will give you provision and sustenance, will make it easier for you when you make the hijrah في سبيل الله. Then he said سبحانه وتعالى ومن يخرج من بيته مهاجرا إلى الله ورسوله ثم يدركه الموت. Okay. So everyone makes the hijrah. He can reach to the other side. Some of them die in between. Okay, yeah, for example, from Mecca to Medina, more than 400 kilometers. So some of them, or few of them, can die. They will not reach. Okay, will they get the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Again, وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, following him, ثُمَّ يُدْرِكُ الْمَوْتِ, death comes to him, فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Okay, so the hijrah to Allah and his messenger, and the reward from Allah only, the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives you the reward. The reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they mention a hadith. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma said, خَرَجَ ضَمْرَ ابن جندب من بيتي مهاجرا. He left from his house. He left his house hijra, migrating. Then he said to his people, احملوني, carry me, which means, or yeah, support me, which means he was not strong enough to make the hijra alone. He needs support. فأخرجوني من أرض المشركين, take me out from the land of shirk, سبحان الله, إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, to the prophet, to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فمات في الطريق. Then he died in between. قبل أن يصل إلى النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, before reaching the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, then Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed this ayah. And also this hadith in Tabarani, Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله mentioned this in his صحيح book. Another hadith, الزبير بن العوام رضي الله تعالى عنه قال, هاجر خالد بن حزام إلى أرض الحبشة. Okay, خالد بن حزام, he migrated to الحبشة, which means this is before, this was before the time of هجرة to Medina. Also it is هجرة, also it is هجرة. The scholars call this هجرة. I mean, it is also migration. There were two migrations before the migration to Medina, two times to الحبشة. فنهشته حية في الطريق. A snake bite him. And he died. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah in Surah An-Nisa. طيب, so وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكُ الْمَوْتِ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. And whoever leaves his home as an immigrant to Allah and his messenger, and then death overtakes him, his reward has already become incumbent upon Allah, and Allah is ever forgiving and merciful. سبحانه وتعالى وكان الله غفورا رحيما. What do we learn from this ayah? The main rule: من ترك شيئا لله عوضه الله خيرا منه. Anyone leaves something for the sake of Allah, Allah will replace him better. This is a very important rule for us in this dunya. If you leave something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace you. But what is the condition? It should be في سبيل الله. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who knows your intention. If you don't get what is better, make sure about your intention and be patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace you. And there are many examples. Many examples. And for example, one of the famous examples, Salama. I will not say she left something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but when she put her trust in Allah, Allah will replace. When her husband Abu Salam, one of the great companions, passed away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced her with the best man, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad. She was one of the wives of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the mothers of the believers. Her husband Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And when the يعني you see the stories, you will find many stories about those who left something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times you hear stories that someone left a job, okay, good salary and يعني good place, but they left that job because it has riba, there is women, fitna, for something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني gave them something better, much much better than what they left. So this is a rule, من ترك شيئا لا عوض الله خيرا من. Also that the slave could get the full reward, the slave gets the full reward, okay, when his intention is good and sound. فقد الله سبحانه وتعالى says فقد وقع أجره على الله. His reward, he died, he did not complete his deed, okay. His deed is to migrate from, for example, from Mecca to Medina. After 100 kilos, after 200 kilos, he passed away in the middle. He did not see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He did not reach Medina. So his deed is not complete, but his reward, perfect. And we have the famous story when the man who killed 100 people, okay, then he asked a scholar for a repentance. He said, yes, you can't repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can stop you from repentance, but you change your place. So subhanallah, he left. This is hijra fi sabilillah. This person, the killer, he killed 100 people. He left his place to the pious, the righteous land. But subhanallah, he was not in the middle. He was before the middle. So the distance was, okay, he was closer to the bad land, not the good land. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angels and they measured what is the distance, because you know the angels of punishment and the angels of mercy, both of them, okay, there was a discussion, we should take his soul, the angels of the punishment. Why? Because he killed 100 people. Subhanallah, this is very bad. Killing one soul is very dangerous. What about killing 100? We should take his soul. But the mercy, the angels of mercy, they say, no, we should take his soul because he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it was revealed to them, you should measure the distance. He is closer to which land? He was closer to the bad land. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the order to the land, anta qarrabi. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the order to the bad land, anta ba'adi. Okay, be further, huh? Farthest. And awha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ila Allah, give the order to the land of the righteous people, and taqarrabi, be closer. So when the angels came to measure the distance, they found him closer to the good and righteous people. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change for you the measures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change the measures for you. Like Yusha alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, we are not prophets. Okay, but also that man, we are not prophets like Yusha. I mean, Yusha alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah stopped the sun for him. Allah stopped the time. Because what does it mean to stop the sun? The time stopped. Okay, so Allah, he's a messenger. Okay, but this man, he's not a messenger. He was a criminal, subhanAllah, but he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah changed the rules for him. How to bring this land to him and this land to send it away from him. How? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change the rules for you, for his slaves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this man, okay, I mean the killer of 100 people, he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted him before he reached to the, yani before he completed his deed, the hijra. Okay, so here, this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, karam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He gives you more than what you deserve. You deserve little reward, but Allah gives you the full reward. I did not finish my deed, but Allah will give you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this example, they did not finish their hijrah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the full reward. And when the Prophet said, in one of the ghazwa, one of the battles, he told them, some of you will get the reward. When we do anything, when we walk any distance, they are with us in the reward. At home, we are struggling. The sun heat, the thirst, and the hunger, and the animals. طيب. And some people at home getting with us the same reward. How? The Prophet said, حبسهم العذر, because of the excuse. Maybe he is sick, he could not join us in the jihad, or maybe one of his people, one of his family members. Like Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, one of the battles, he did not join the Prophet and he got the reward. Why? Because he was with his wife, she was sick. This is an excuse. And also, we can learn from this ayah, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. If there is a difficulty, there is ease. If there is a difficulty, there is ease. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Okay, why you immigrate in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because of the troubles. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you, يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. You will find the ease. And also, you learn from this ayah, if you please your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the success in dunya wal akhirah. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. You will find in dunya. Okay, the ease. And also the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the akhirah. And also we learn from this ayah, the death comes behind you. Because if you notice here, the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ يُدْرِكُ الْمَوْتِ. What does يُدْرِكُ الْمَوْتِ? As if the death is following you. Yours came from death, and the death is following you. So whatever you do, death is coming, is coming. خلاص. طيب, أينما الله سبحانه وتعالى says, أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت. ولو كنت في بروج مشيدة. Wherever you are, death catches you. Even if you are in the very high places. يا بني اركب, نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام said to his son, يا بني اركب معنا. Join us in the ark. ولا تكن مع الكافرين. Don't be with the disbelievers. قال سآوي إلى جبل يعصمني من الماء. Don't worry about that. I can protect myself. I can climb this big mountain. And I can save myself. Subhanallah. قال لا عاصم اليوم من أمر الله إلا من رحم. No one can protect himself from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except those who got the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means the believers. Subhanallah. So wherever you go, death is coming to you. Death will catch you. So this is the fact. That's why he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أكثروا ذكرى هادم للذات. We should, repeatedly remember the death. Don't forget the death. And also, from the ayah, the reward from Allah. Only from Allah. He said, you do the hijrah to Allah and His Messenger, but the reward is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, that the reward more than our deeds. The reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than our deeds. How many ayat, how many ahadith, when we read, you'll find the great reward, very small deed. You come to the masjid, and you, for example, Jum'ah. When you walk to the, you make the ghusl, and you walk to the Jum'ah, how much reward you will get? You stay after the salah, you say dhikr, subhanallah, 10 times, alhamdulillah, 10 times, Allah Akbar, 10 times, how many times? 30 times. You'll get reward 300. طيب if you fast one day which is Ashura, Allah forgives 1 year. You fast one day Arafah, Allah forgives 2 years. So you will find many examples in the Sharia doing very small deed. We think it is very small, but it is huge. You will get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the name of Allah, Ash-Shakur. Ash-Shakur, what is the meaning of Ash-Shakur? Ash-Shakur from Shukr, gratitude, thanking. Okay, it means the one who gives a lot for something little. The one who gives a lot for something very little. Allah is a shakur. We do very little and He gives a lot. We do very little. Okay? If you pray day and night, if you pray day and night, if you are in the masjid praying, sujood, rukur, you don't eat, you don't, okay, for 70 years, 80 years, okay, imagine if you are praying, imagine, without sleep, without food, no toilet, nothing, no family. You are only in the masjid for salah. طيب, you will get the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, paradise forever. So this is much, much more than my worship. I'm worshiping Allah for example 70 years, 80 years, but you will get an eternal reward from Allah because He is al-shakur, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, the one who takes this, you know, this kind of difficulty, hijrah, because it is not easy to migrate. This is not easy. Okay, sometimes you have the time to sell your house and your car, and sometimes no time. Yeah, for example, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated. Okay, do you think he put his things in groups and I have furniture, I have a bird, I have a cat. He left Mecca in a hidden way. It was very difficult. So, you know, sometimes you migrate without taking anything with you. Yes, sometimes there is time. Okay, you do your paperwork, you finish your things. Sometimes. Also, if you have time, it is not easy. Not easy to leave your land. I was born here, grow here, school, college, marriage, children. But now I leaving my country, my home. In the case of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is not easy. It's not easy. But be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. يجد في الأرض مراغما كثيرا وسعة. So this is a glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who are thinking a lot. Okay, yes, it is difficult. Yes, no doubt. It's difficult. It's very difficult to leave your country. But you should think about the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For sure, it is not easy for many people to leave their country. But remember this ayah. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. This is a glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, this is a very important ayah that we should be detached from the mushrikeen. Not to be, because what is the concept of hijrah? We said hijrah to leave. So you are leaving the shirk. You are leaving the mushrik. Not to be with them. Not to live with them. So this is a very important concept. And also that the concept of hijrah, you leave your money. Okay, what does it mean that you leave your country? You leave also your money. So we need to sacrifice in our life. And I think we mentioned many times Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala as an example. He left his home, his family, his wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he did the hijrah. And also they mentioned the example of Suhaib radiallahu ta'ala. You know, when he did the hijrah, the story, he was leaving Mecca. They stopped him. Okay, or they were trying to stop him. Also, you came to us, so look, poor guy. Now you have wealth. He said, you want my money? You go to that place, you take my money and leave me to migrate. So subhanAllah, it was very easy for him. Yalla, you take my money, but the main thing is the hijrah. When it becomes easy for the person, it is difficult. When it becomes easy, when the faith is strong, and the faith is strong, then it will be easy for the Sahaba. When they left the things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how? Because the faith was strong. But if the faith is weak, oh, I think too much. How can I leave my country, keep my study, my friends? So people will think about dunya. If the faith, the iman is weak, so you will think the shaitan will control you. How come you are leaving your car, your house, your job, your family, your friends, your place, and but when your faith is strong, خلاص, everything will be easy. Everything will be bigger than the dunya. I mean about the akhirah. Also, we learn from this ayah that hijrah has many benefits. Yes, you are leaving your country. You are leaving your people. But also, on the other side, there are many benefits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعَى. A lot. Many benefits in the hijrah. Subhanallah. So this is, again, it is a great thing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But subhanallah, the shaitan makes it, the good things very small and the bad things very, very big. So that's why we should fight the shaitan. Also, we learn from this ayah that if someone migrates and he finds the things difficult, okay, not going in a proper way for him, he should check his intention, because this is a condition from Allah. وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qurtubi rahimahullah mentioned something about Imam Malik. He said, this verse is a proof that no, it is not for anyone to stay in a place, okay, the Salaf are insulted there. It is not only from the Muslim, from the Kafir country to the Muslim. If you are in a Muslim country, but, okay, they are not Ahl Sunnah, they are deviant people, they are speaking bad about the Salaf, you should leave the country. Imam Malik, rahimahullah, Qurtubi mentioned that about Imam Malik. If you are in a place, they are insulting the Salaf, they are not respecting the Salaf, okay, and they are not following the Haqq, okay, also you should leave this place. He mentioned this from Imam Malik, rahimahullah ta'ala. And also, and this ayah talks about the hijrah fi sabilillah, from the bad country to the good country. This means it is not allowed to do the opposite, to migrate from the good country to a bad country. Subhanallah. How come? Yes, some people like that. Alhamdulillah, you live in a Muslim country where you can practice your religion, the Salah, Jum'ah, Eid, the Hijab, your beard. You leave this country to a non-Muslim country or to a bad country, okay, just because of dunya, no doubt this is not allowed. This is dangerous, subhanallah. Okay, so this is about the hijrah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the next ayah, وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَقُصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ إِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَن يَفْتِينَكُمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِنَّ الْكَافِرِينَ كَانُوا لَكُمْ عَدُوًا مُبِينًا. And when you are travel, when you travel throughout the land, there is no blame here. وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ, okay, ضرب في الأرض means you travel for jihad, for business. Okay, why, the word ضرب, hit? Why? Because, maybe you are using your stick, so you hit the ground, okay, or your steps. So from this is from where the word ضربتم. طيب, يضرب الأرض. وإذا ضربتم في الأرض, and when you travel throughout the land, there is no blame upon you for shortening the prayer, especially if you fear that those who disbelieve may disrupt or attack you. Indeed, the disbelievers are ever to you a clear enemy. وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ, which means traveling here, for tijara, business, for jihad. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحًا أن تقصروا من الصلاة. Okay, so there is no sin, no blame if you shorten the salah. إن خفتم أن يفتنكم الذين كفروا. If you fear. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned shortening the salah with a condition, which is if you fear. So we understand from this ayah, if we don't fear, then don't shorten the salah. يعلى ابن أمية said, I asked Umar رضي الله تعالى about this ayah. So he said, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, يعني now we are safe. Now we are safe. Okay, this ayah about we shorten the salah if we fear. But now alhamdulillah, Makkah, Medina and the surrounding Muslim countries, no problem. We can travel without any kind of fear from our enemies. Then Umar رضي الله تعالى said, عجبت مما عجبت من. I wondered the same way you are wondering now about this ayah. And I asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about this ayah. يعني يا رسول الله, now we are الحمد لله security and safe, we feel safe. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, صدقة تصدق الله بها عليكم فاقبلوا صدقته. Umar, يعني asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, okay, if we are not feeling, why we are shorting the salah? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, this is a charity from Allah for on us, for us. So we should accept the charity from Allah. خلاص. This ayah, Allah subhanahu revealed this ayah, there is fear, but now there is no fear. Why we are shorting the salah? Oh, Umar, you should accept this is from Allah. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so this is from our Lord, the one who told us to pray for, he told us to pray too. Alhamdulillah. So he said, صَدَقَ تَصَدَّقَ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَصَدَّقَ اللَّهُ بِهَا عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْبَلُوا صَدَقَةَ. You should accept the charity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also another hadith, okay, this hadith in Muslim. Another hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Haritha ibn Wahb رضي الله عنه قال, صلى بنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم آمن ما كان بمنا ركعتين. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed for us. Okay. آمن ما كان, يعني the highest level of security and safety. We were very safe. We're in Mina. This means Hajj. The 10th year. Makkah Muslim, Medina Muslim. Okay. Do we fear anyone? Do we fear Abu Jahl? No, Abu Jahl, no, Abu Lahab, Muslim. He said, Amana Makan, the highest, we were in the highest level of security. He prayed two rak'ah. So this ayah, it mentions the fear, but from the sunnah, this is if you fear and also if you don't fear. You pray, you shorten the salah. Major scholars say about shortening the salah is sunnah. And there is another opinion which says it is wajib. It is compulsory. Why? Because he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, faqbalu, you should accept this. Okay, you should accept this. And Hadith Aisha, that the salah was two rak'ah. Then salatu safar uqirrat, the travel salah uqirrat stayed as it was, and salat al-hadar zidat. And the salah, when you are in your place, in your country, it was more. So that's why some scholars said it is wajib, but major scholars said it is mustahab. Okay, and it is the sunnah to pray, to shorten the salah. So when you are traveling, you shorten the salah without a doubt. Don't say, huh? No, it's better to pray for. Okay, I'm sitting, I have time. What is the point to shorten the salah? The point is the sunnah. So you shorten the salah. Following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And always I like to mention the point that not always the shorting the salah with combining the two salah. Because there is a common mistake people mention that جمع قصر. You combine and you shorten. Okay? No, not necessary. When you shorten the salah, you combine. You can shorten the salah alone. You pray dhuhr to rak'ah alone. Then at the time of asr, you pray to rak'ah alone. Al-maghrib, 3 rak'ah alone. Isha, 2 rak'ah alone. So not necessary that the jam' with qasr. So, yani, always I'm trying to correct people. When you travel, no need to make the jam', always you make the jam'. You combine dhuhr asr together, maghrib isha together. If you are, yeah, for example, you visit some of your relatives in another country, you are there 3 days, 4 days, خلاص, you are in the hotel, or in the, you are in their house. What I notice sometimes, يعني someone traveling, for example, visiting us from Saudi, we go and pray dhuhr, okay, they go pray dhuhr, but after dhuhr, immediately they pray al-asr. Then al-asr time, alhamdulillah, we did jam. I will not say it is haram. It is not haram. Okay? Why? Because they are allowed, the traveler, the travelers, to shorten and to make jam. Sorry, it is sunnah to shorten, and it is allowed for them to make jam, to combine. But it's better. This is ittifaq. Okay? It is agreed upon among the scholars. Okay? To pray every salah on time. If you are not driving, يعني the hadith كان إذا جد به السير. When you make the jam, it's better to make the jam. إذا جد به السير. What does it mean جد به السير? I'm driving now. خلاص يعني maybe 10 a.m. يلا I start from Kuwait. I'm going to Mecca. So if you start here 10, you reach the border about 12. It's this time of dhuhr. خلاص you make jam. The sunnah it's better you make jam. You combine dhuhr asr. Because I'm driving. خلاص المغرب time I'm driving. طيب so you stop the time for المغرب or you stop the time for Isha. And it's better you make a jam. Don't say no I want to pray on time. No this is not sunnah. The sunnah you combine. طيب but when you reach your destination Mecca, Medina, Jeddah, Taif, Abha, whatever. Okay you are there. I'm there in Abha. I am in Taif for 5 days, 6 days. خلاص, you pray on time. It's better you pray on time. Or you go to the masjid. But when you go to the masjid, you pray the full salah, 4 rak'ah. Don't shorten. Okay, you pray with the imam, 4 rak'ah, if you are praying with the jama'ah. So the sunnah is al-qasr. The sunnah is al-qasr. But al-jam', okay, it depends. If you are driving, or I'm in the airport, going transit from one airport to another airport, or after the airport, I need to find a bus or a car, then driving 3 hours, do the jam. It's better you do the jam. طيب. So in this ayah, and in the hadith, we came to conclusion that the qasr is sunnah until the day of judgment. It is not only for the fear, if you fear or if you don't fear. طيب. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَنْ تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ. Okay, so فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَنْ تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ. So here, there is no blame, no sin, if you shorten the salah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it is not a sin. There is no blame. So why we say it is sunnah? Like, if you remember Surah Al-Baqarah, إِنَّ الصَّفَ وَالْمَرْوَةَ مِنْ شَعَارِ اللَّهِ فَمَنْ حَجَّ الْبَيْتَ وَاعْتَمَرَ فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَطَّوَّفَ بِهِمَا. فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِ, يعني there is no blame, there is no sin if you do the tawaf between الصَّفَ وَالْمَرْوَةَ. So can we say it is allowed you do tawaf or you don't do tawaf? No, it is a condition for the Hajj and Umrah. You do the sa'i between الصَّفَ وَالْمَرْوَةَ. So here it is sunnah to shorten the salah. إن خفتم أن يفتنكم الذين كفروا إن الكافرين كان لكم عدوا مبينا. So what do we learn from this ayah? That the kuffar, okay, the kuffar, they don't stop or يعني they will not be comfortable when they see Muslims feel, يعني living in peace. their job is planning to destroy our life, to destroy the Muslims, okay, to make the life as a hell for us. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْكَافِرِينَ كَانُوا لَكُمْ عَدُوًا مُبِينًا. They are clear, obvious enemy for us, subhanallah, for the Muslim, for the Muslims. So this is their job. Okay. And also, we learn from this ayah that the salah is one of the mandatory things in our life. So you are traveling, you are in your country, you fear, you don't fear, you have to pray. You have to pray. Okay, so the ayah, if you notice, وَإِذْ ضَرَبْتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحًا تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ إِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَنْ يَفْتِنَكُمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. طيب, so and when you travel throughout the land, there is no blame upon you for shorting the prayer, especially if you fear that those who disbelieve. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not tell us, if you fear, don't pray. Shorten the salah. So if you have an exam, we don't pray because there is an exam. Allah did not say that. So you'll find sometimes Muslims, subhanAllah, for anything, they don't pray. Wallahi, I am sick. Okay, pray. I have operation. They don't pray. I have problem. They don't pray. I lost my job. Okay, if you lost your job, you should pray more. Tayyib, so this is, subhanAllah, very dangerous. That when people go through a calamity, a problem, you notice them far from the religion. Okay, the woman has a problem, she removes the hijab, she removes niqab. Why? Well, I am doing the hijab and niqab and I'm struggling my job and my life and my with my husband, with my children, with my parents. Okay, maybe you have a problem in your faith. Maybe it is a test. Allah subhanahu wants to increase. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best man, okay, and he is the messenger of Allah, and he was his people fighting him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Doesn't mean that Islam was wrong. They are wrong, not Islam. So you should be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the tyrant king took the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, what he did, he prayed. He prayed, alayhi salatu, he was praying. He was invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you are struggling, you should be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read more Quran, give more charity, correct your intention. Maybe you have a problem with your intention. So this is very important, that the salah, you should not stop the salah for anything. And inshallah it will come, the coming ayat about the rules of the salah during the battle, if there is a battle. So we should not stop the salah. Don't stop the salah, whatever you have. Tayyib, also this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَنْ تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this ayah, did not mention the distance of the travel. Yes, there are different opinions about the traveling. But actually in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention when you travel 80 kilos, or when you travel 3 days, when you travel 1 day. Okay, so this is is a support for the opinion which says that the travel is not related to the distance. It is related with what people know. So for us, for example, here in Kuwait, when I go to Jahra, we say, I am traveling to Jahra. No, we are not traveling to Jahra. When, for example, Jum'ah day, after Jum'ah, okay, many people, they go where? So, Khairan, okay? Not so. Yes. He's traveling. He stamped the passport, huh? People go to Khairan, the chalet. Or in winter, we go to the camp. Okay, sometimes we drive maybe 45 minutes, 1 hour. طيب. But this is not traveling. This is not traveling. Yeah, maybe after Isha, I pray Isha here. Then I go to have the dinner there with the friends. Maybe I drive 1 hour. Okay, stay there. Maybe class, one halqa, dinner. Then I come home. This is not traveling. I mean, what people know, that going to the coming the same day, it is not traveling. طيب, but maybe in some places it is traveling. So what is common among people? As a trouble, so this is a trouble. Okay, so العرف, what is known, what is common, this is our reference. This is our reference. طيب. Also, يعني, to tell, this ayah tells you the importance of salah. The importance of salah. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ خَيْرَ أَعْمَالِكُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. And know that the best of your deeds is الصَّلَاةِ. الصَّلَاةِ. وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ خَيْرَ أَعْمَالِكُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Yes, number one is the tawheed, the aqeedah. But what about the deeds? The best thing is الصَّلَاةِ. What do we mean by the الصَّلَاةِ? We mean the fard, the five prayers. This is the main thing in our actions and in our deeds. And when people, subhanAllah, stick to the salah, you will find their situation is much better. But when people ignore the salah, don't care about the salah, Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, they don't care about the salah. You will find them like animals, subhanAllah. Like animals, they live for what? If they are not praying for their desire, for their stomach, subhanAllah. But when there is salah, the time of salah, wallahi, this is ni'mah. The salah is ni'mah. Yes, it is a duty on us, but also, you know, this is a kind of duty that we enjoy. يعني, the salah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, arihna biha ya Bilal. You are tired, confused from the many issues. Fighting, angry, discussion, argument, meetings. When you come to the salat, خلاص. If you are praying the proper way, طيب, wallahi, you will enjoy your time during the salah. You like to prolong the salah. طيب, so the salah is ni'mah. People think, well, this makes the life difficult. It makes the life difficult if the person is not Muslim. He's not a strong Muslim. طيب, it is difficult for him. But alhamdulillah, for those who are praying on time, believing this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is easy. Alhamdulillah. يعني, the companions are the best people. They were praying the five prayers on time. يعني, the five prayers did not make their life difficult, did not make their ummah, their nation, the lowest nation. It's the opposite. They became the best nation. If your salah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, فإذا صلحت, صلحت. When your salah is sound, then the remaining deeds will be good. So this is the leading deed, the salah. It is your leader. So, you know, when you pass the exam of al-fajr, then you are najih, you are faiz, you are winner. This is the first exam. Every day we have the first exam is Fajr Salah. When you pray on time, you are a winner. Okay. You are not a winner when you go, you punch the car, the first person. I punch seven. Okay, but where are you in the masjid? Where are you the time of the salah? So from this ayah, the importance of salah and the position of the salah. And also we learn from this ayah, if the safar, the travel finish, then you should pray the full salah. You should pray the full salah. Khalas, I reached home, I have to pray four rak'ah. So when you reach, yeah, for example, you reach the airport, the time of Maghrib. Sorry, the time of Isha. Because Maghrib always three rak'ah. You reach time of Isha. But still you are in the airport waiting your luggage. How many rak'ah you should pray? Four. I should pray four. No, but still I am at the airport. But khalas, you are not in trouble. You are not in trouble. You reached home, you have to pray the four rak'ah. So this ayah means that when the travel finish, then you pray the full salah, the four rak'ah. If you are a traveler, you shorten the salah. You are not a traveler, you should pray the four rak'ah. And also, يعني from this ayah, we should be careful from the kuffar. Whatever they show us, but you should believe Allah. You should remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them. They are our enemies. Okay, no, of course, no doubt. It doesn't mean I don't trust anything. I don't buy anything from them, and I don't accept any food from them. Doesn't mean that, but I mean, as general, the kuffar are our enemies. Because they disbelieve in Allah, and we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the only true God subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the Prophet Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, the sunnah clarifies the Quran. This is very important. For those who claim that they are Quraniyun, they follow only the Quran is enough, okay, this is wrong. Because the Quran tells you to follow the sunnah. So how we came to this ruling, I mean shortening the salah if you are a traveler, because the sunnah clarified that when Umar radiallahu anhu asked the Prophet ﷺ. Without that hadith, then khalas. And the Quran says, if you fear, you shorten the salah. So no doubt we need the Quran and the sunnah. We need the Quran and sunnah. Both of them wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, when you read the ayah here, وَإِذَا ضَرَبْتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحًا أَن تَقْصُرُ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ إِنْ خِفْتُمْ if you fear, أَن يَفْتِنَكُمْ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا if you fear the kuffar. You understand from this ayah that in the rules of Islam, and this will come inshallah, the next ayah, in the rules of Islam, you will find that I shorten the salah, I don't stop the salah, I shorten the salah. Why? Because I don't want to give chance for the kuffar to attack us or to defeat us. So look at the flexibility of Sharia. Don't pray for two rak'ah. You are a traveler? Okay, you can wipe up to 3 days. You wipe on your leather socks. Al-Khuf. We mentioned the rules in Tuesday halqa. So what is the point here? Or one of the points that you should be careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us these rules, okay, to be ready for the kuffar. So this is very important to keep our eyes open. خُدُوا حِذْرَكُمْ Take your precautions. We mentioned this ayah. Take your precautions. The Muslim should be alert. He should not be following whatever they say. No, I should know what they are doing. I should be awake, aware. This is the Muslim, the Prophet. What is the meaning of the hadith? What do you understand from the hadith? The Prophet ﷺ said, "La yuldagh al-mu'min min juhrin marratayn." The believer should not be bitten from the same hole twice. It means I should be awake. I should learn from my mistakes. But what is the problem now? It is not only twice, maybe 100 times. Subhanallah. It is from the same source, the same weapon. The Muslims are stabbed from the same place. Why? Because we don't care. We are not awake. We are not following the Quran and Sunnah. So this is very important that we should be awake. Inshallah, we should stop here. Continue next time. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
If I'm traveling and I'm staying in a particular place for a week and it's a non-Muslim country and there are no masajids, so if I'm at home, so do I pray the 4 rakats or I pray 2 rakats?
You are a traveler?
I'm traveling but in a non-Muslim country, but I'm staying there for a week.
Okay. Yeah. So I pray 4 rakats. What is your question about
Do I pray 2 rakats if I'm in the, for example, in the hotel and I'm staying for a week? So I pray 2 rakats or 4 rakats?
No, the sunnah you pray 2 rak'ah, you shorten the salah. Because you are a traveler. You are in a Muslim country or in a non-Muslim country. You pray 2 rak'ah.
Maybe he's trying to say he's staying for more than 4 days.
I know, you are a traveler. Khalas, you have this label, you are musafir. You pray 2 rak'ah.
Announcement about that. Instagram and we're going to go live.
From next week? Next week or next month?
First week, September.
Inshallah, lectures will be Zoom, inshallah. The live will be Zoom, mainly Zoom, huh? From September.
Suppose I went from here to Canada. And then I'm staying with my children.
Okay.
Am I a traveler or?
As you said, you travel to a place, you are staying with your children. So you are a traveler. It's not your country. So where is your home country? Where you have your house, your job, your car, your friends, your neighbors, your normal activities. But you are visiting them. You are visiting them. So if this is the case that I am visiting them for 1 month, so you are traveling. But you know, sometimes it is a home here and home here. Okay, when I am here, it is my home. When I go there, also it is my home. Because I have this is my house, I have my car, my neighbors, my friends, and I go to my masjid. Okay, so you don't shorten the salah then. Because also this is your home.
Sheikh,
but you shorten the salah. You are visiting them.
That's a question. Travel be for how many days? 3 days or more than that?
If you are a traveler, no, he's for 1 day, 10 days, 20 days, 2 months, 3 months, 1 month, you are a traveler. Okay.
There is no bindings for the days.
No. Yes, there is opinion 4 days, there is opinion 19 days, there is opinion 6 days, and there is opinion, there is no limit for being a traveler. So what people consider you as a traveler, oh, you are a traveler. Okay, so sometimes it is 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Okay, you know, sometimes people travel for attending a course or for a treatment. Okay. We should not consider the one who's traveling and from his country and finding a job, wallah, he's a traveler. He's staying in the country 10 years, he's a traveler. Yes, it's not your country. But you have your things, you are living as a resident.
So those who go back to their home country and the holidays also, they will not consider.
So, again, what we consider them, okay, now you are here in Kuwait. This is not your country. Your country is Pakistan. So when you go to Pakistan, what you say? Wallahi, I'm visiting Pakistan. It depends. Okay, so when you say I'm visiting Pakistan for a holiday, then you are traveler. There you are traveler, not here. But as I said, sometimes people go here and there, and there is a house here, and there is a house here, and there is a normal life here, a normal life here. Both sides.
Two ways.
Sheikh, I have a question.
Be careful.
Sheikh, for example, I'm going to Saudi, and I know there are masajids, when I'm driving. So I pray, for example, at the border, I get duhur. Okay, I pray duhur, but I know that I'm going to reach, in between Riyadh, there is a town where I can pray asr. So
no, the sunnah you join.
So I know, but I will reach Asr there.
I know, but now you are driving. Okay? What does it mean? Jadda bihi khalas, he's driving. He is riding his horse or his camel, alayhi salatu wasalam. So now I'm driving. I know I will reach the time of Maghrib, Asr. Or I reach before Asr. Okay? No, now you are a traveler. In the process of shifting from one place to another place, do the jam.
Also the opposite.
Okay, you are in the border of Dhuhr time and you reach before Asr in Kuwait. Yeah, suppose that the Adhan Dhuhr were in Sanmi. So what is the distance? You need maybe 1.5 hours. Okay, so you reach here Kuwait maybe 2:30. Do the jam' there, Qasr. Do jam' and Qasr. You pray Dhuhr to Rak'ah, then Asr to Rak'ah. And when you reach home, you sleep.
Why do people say about only 4 days and it's like 70 kilometers?
There is an opinion. There is opinion. Many scholars they say it is 4 days. Huh?
Is there any weak hadith?
No, no, not. No, the issue is not weak hadith. The issue is with the hadith, with understanding the hadith. Because why? Okay, why there is opinion for 4 days, 19 days? Okay, because there is a hadith. The Prophet ﷺ stayed in Tabuk 19 days doing doing qasr in Tabuk. There is 19 days, one night. There is hadith about the 4 days. So, you know, when... Okay, like, you know, the famous opinion that Jum'ah, at least, should be 40 people, right? This is Hanbali, and I think Shafi'i, okay? If people are less than 40, then don't do Jum'ah. Why they say? Because they took an occasion during the time of Rasulullah SAW. There was a masjid, and there were 40 people prayed the Jum'ah. So some of the scholars said, they pray when they were 40 people, they prayed Jum'ah. It means it is a condition if there are 40 people, or we should have 40 people. Okay, but the other scholars said, no, it is not a condition to have 40 people. But it happened like that. 40 people came to the masjid, and they prayed Jum'ah. So the same issue here. The Prophet ﷺ, he went 19 days and he was making qasr. Okay, so it can be 19 days or 17 days, 20 days. So what happened, it is not a condition. What happened is not a condition. Okay, and that's why, and this hadith 19, okay, and another hadith 4 days. So which one we take? We don't take any one of them. Why? Because this happened, it happened like that, within four days. And also those who said 4 days, okay, you'll find them different. Why? Because they said 4 days with one, the day in and the day out or without. So you'll find different opinion, different way in understanding this opinion. So that's why the other opinion, it is Allah Alam stronger, like Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, okay, that if you are traveling, you follow the rules of traveling without limited number of days or distance.
Sheikh, now you mentioned that if you are traveling and you are praying in the masjid, you have to follow the
imam.
So what about the ladies? They can pray 2 rakats at home?
Yes. The sunnah for them to pray 2 rakats, the ladies at home.
Someone is asking, if we stay in our relative's house and we have a lot of time, can we pray complete salah?
No, the sunnah to pray 2 rak'ah. You have enough time, you pray 2 rak'ah. Don't pray 4 rak'ah. No, I am sitting with my relatives or in my hotel. I'm sitting like, and suppose that I went for a conference. Okay, you know, sometimes you go only for 3 days, conference. What is the time of conference? In the morning, from 8 to 12. What is the time for dhuhr? 1. So halas, I came home. After 12, I'm sitting at home only for eating. Okay, they offered me the 3 meals. Breakfast, lunch, dinner. I'm sitting there. Okay, the sunnah you pray 2. Don't pray 4. If you are in the hotel, you pray 2. Don't pray 4. Okay, if you go to the masjid, you pray.
There is one question, but it is not related to this thing. It's from a lady.
Mm.
For a woman whose husband died and she is in her idda, is it allowed for her to use a cream because her face skin
cream.
Because her face skin gets very dry? Is it considered beautification?
No, as she mentioned, she wants to use this cream as a treatment, moisturizing. Okay, it is not for the smell. So no doubt, it is allowed. I use some cream to, for eczema, for moisture, no problem.